On his own show, my friend and Fox colleague Glenn Beck has tirelessly exposed the disturbing growth of government. And government is never more disturbing than it wields the power to kill. President Obama has recently asserted the right to have suspected al-Qaeda members assassinated overseas, even if they are American citizens, and even without any trial. There are few things more disturbing than this. Can we trust a government to be respectful to the rule of law here?
Wait, there was more?
Yeah.
You can end it at, can we trust government?
Well,
no. No government, ever. George Washington, ever. Government is fire. It is fire. When you understand it's fire, great, you won't get burned.
It's fear and it's force. But
yes.
This government, and as did its predecessor under President Bush, has claimed an extraordinary power to kill Americans without charge, without trial, without jury, without evidence, because it fears them and they're overseas.
If you see the conversations that have happened, the papers that have gone back and forth between Cass Sunstein, Elena Kagan, talking about can people just be picked up off the street, can they be held without trial on suspicion of being involved in any kind of terrorist organization. Now we've kicked it up a notch. Now we can shoot you, an American citizen. Judge, is that not murder?
Of course it's murder. You and I have talked about this, and I'm scandalized by it. This came out 4 months ago, and it was buried in the newspapers.
Yeah.
When the Washington Post, we just heard from Dana Priest, when the Washington Post exposed it this week, suddenly people are talking about it. Why aren't they rioting in the streets? Why aren't there a million people outside the White House saying you took an oath to uphold the law? You can't kill people.
I don't know, Judge. I don't know. But I think this week with the financial bill, I think we've put the final nail in the coffin of the Republic. I really do. And now we have, if you read, next week we're exposing on the show what I think is the blueprint for what this administration is doing. It is from the Weather Underground, 1968. If you look at it, it's all being done. And one of them is to have civil unrest, to control the economy, and then to insert a dictator. That's their words.
You gave me this to read over the weekend when we were together in Salt Lake City, and I read it, and it terrified me, and it is written in the jargon and lingo of Marxist students in 1969 when I was in college.
Now, when you take that and if you adapt that language and just wash that language and wash the Marxism out of it, and you take, look in the thesaurus. Another word for transformation is? Revolution.
And that's,
revolution. Well, that's what we're doing right now. We're having a revolution.
Is this the way government grows? We arrested people, some on the battlefield, some we don't know how we got them in Guantanamo Bay. We said we could hold them without trial. Very few of them have been tried. Now we say we can do that to Americans?
Yeah, we can.
And now we say we can kill Americans?
Yeah.
How can a government claim the power to do the opposite of what it was elected to do?
I have no idea, Joe.
If they can kill Americans, go ahead.
If you're on the battlefield and you're fighting against, none of this BS, that if I'm fighting against you and I'm on the battlefield, I'm shooting you.
Absolutely.
I'm shooting you.
But if I am sitting in a mosque and saying words that the president doesn't like, he can send his agents to assassinate me?
Tell me, Judge. Where do you go from here? Where else do you go? They now, under the financial bill, can take and seize your company if they deem you're a threat. If the president and the NSA deems that you are a threat to this nation in a terroristic way, they don't pick you up and charge you and put you through court. You don't have any constitutional rights. They kill you.
And in 2 weeks, a person will join the Supreme Court who believes in that philosophy, and she'll sit for 40 years articulating into the fabric of law the philosophy that the progressives, the people who can tell us how to run our lives better than we can ourselves, can kill us if we get in the way.
You tell me, Judge. We had the press. I exposed this week on Journalist. It's a group of journalists behind closed doors. They are having conversations where they are they're telling the government to shut Fox News down.
If the government can kill somebody in Kabul, can they kill them in Hackensack? If the government can seize somebody in Yemen, can they seize somebody out of a studio in New York City?
Kagan will tell you yes. So will Cass Sunstein. He will tell you yes.
And
everything, remember, the difference between revolution and a progressive is revolution is for Marxist. Progressives make progress. It's evolution. So you start here, And you just add, and you just add, and you just add. We now have a government that doesn't have to ask Congress for any kind of bailout. The president signs it today, looks right in the camera and says, now we don't have any more bailouts, we don't have to do that. It says in the bill that he can take over anything he wants at his discretion along with the Treasury Secretary, and they can bail out unending and never have to ask us for a dime with the help of the Fed. What has happened to the Republic in a short year and a half time?
What terrifying times we live in. Glenn, thanks for joining us.
The government